dear students, good morning. We all are here back again for today's session on 5th of August 2020 to continue with subject physics. From last session, that is from 27th of July, we started with the chapter number 3, Kinetic Theory of Gases and Radiations. In last session, we discussed the behavior of surface or object. In general, let us say body, when it is exposed to heat radiations. We also define coefficients assigned with the body, coefficient of absorption A, coefficient of reflection R, coefficient of transmission T, and we also discussed all the formula relating all these three, A plus R plus T is equal to 1. These constants are associated with each and every body. We studied few applications of these constants as well as the applications based on the equation A plus R plus T is equal to 1. We will discuss few more before proceeding. In exercise of this chapter, there is MCQ number 4 from question number 1. The exercise is on page number 73. Also, in question number 2, point number 5, the question is based on the same topic. Also, question number 7, you can solve from the exercise which is related with the same above topic. Solve all these three questions in the notebook, and that is your first assignment of the day. Today we'll proceed further to study one more important feature of everybody. This feature gives us idea about ability of emissive capacity of thermal radiation for the body. Every body has capacity to radiate radiant heat to its surrounding. At all times, at all temperatures except absolute zero, these radiations at all times are continuous. They can never be stopped, but they can be minimized. Scientist Prevost put forward the theory of heat exchange between body and its surrounding. This theory is useful to talk about the rate of emission, the rate of absorption, interlinking between these two rates, and interaction of the body with the surrounding related with its thermal properties. On the basis of the theory suggested by Prevost, we define few terms and then we'll proceed further to get mathematical relation between them. We first define rate of emission. Energy emitted by the body per unit second is called its rate of emission. Now we proceed further with rate of absorption. energy absorbed by the body from its surrounding in the form of radiation per second is called its rate of absorption. In short, we discuss about emissive rate and absorptive rate of the body at the given temperature.
Let's have a quick look on Prevost theory and its explanation.
We are familiar with absorptive rate of the body. We'll now discuss emissive rate of the body. The heat radiated by the body at given temperature depends on its surface area and the time duration. It is experimentally proved the heat radiated by the body proportional to its surface area as well as proportional to the time duration. In short, we write Q proportional to A into T. That is, Q is equal to RAT, where R is a constant for the given body. We get the equation R is equal to Q upon AT. With this equation, we proceed further now. The constant R is very important, which is associated with the body. It is energy radiated per unit area per unit time. If A is equal to 1, T is equal to 1, R is equal to energy radiated Q. This constant or this term is called emissive power of a given body. The quantity Q by T is energy radiated per unit time. Energy per time we can term as power. So indirectly we can write R as power radiated per unit area of the body. The quantity emissive power of the body is very important. Its symbol is capital R. We consider this quantity in detail. This is article 3.12 from the book. Emissive power R is temperature dependent. Value of emissive power at a given temperature we have to define henceforth. At a different temperature, given body has different values of emissive powers. When we have number of bodies of different material maintained at same temperature, then it is found at the same temperature perfectly black body has maximum emissive power. It is represented by symbol R0. Emissive power does not depend on temperature of the surrounding. For the given body, value of R depends only on its temperature at that instant. So R independent of temperature of the surrounding. Mathematically, all these four we can write as R naught always greater than R for any ordinary body at given temperature T. R naught R independent of temperature of the surrounding. We'll proceed further for the next point. Now we'll define dimensions and units of emissive power. Its dimensions are M, L, T, 1, 0, minus 3. n1, n0, t-3 are its dimensions. Its units are in SI system by the formula R is equal to Q upon area into time. Energy is in joule, area in meter square and time in second. That is, SI unit thus is joule per second meter square. While solving numerics, generally we get value of emissive power expressed in SI unit as watt per meter square, because joule per second, energy per time is power. Hence, alternative unit of emissive power in SI system mainly mentioned while solving numeric is watt per square meter. In CGS units, we write the same energy in earths, time as in second, and area in square centimeter. Hence, CGS unit of emissive power is earth per square centimeter second. One of the most important properties of emissive power, that is energy radiated in the form of heat by the body per unit area per unit time, is the function of temperature of the body. The dependence of emissive power with temperature is studied and stated by Stefan Boltzmann, and it is labeled as Stefan Boltzmann law of radiation. This law is experimentally proved by scientist Stefan and theoretically verified by scientist Boltzmann, hence labeled as Stefan's Boltzmann's law. It is also called Stefan's fourth power law. This law only deals with energy radiated by the body. It does not deal any more with energy absorbed by the body from its surrounding. Please note down theoretical statement of Stefan's Boltzmann law in your notebook right now. I will dictate and you have to write it.
Statement: the rate of emission of radiant energy per unit area is directly proportional to the fourth power of its absolute temperature.
Mathematically, we relate emissive power of body at a given temperature R proportional to fourth power of its absolute temperature T, that is R proportional to T raised to 4. The same we write R is equal to sigma T raised to 4, where sigma is called Stefan's constant. Stefan constant carries SI unit. Let us find SI unit of sigma, R divided by T raised to 4. Therefore, in SI system, we write it as R watt per square meter. And absolute zero measured in Kelvin, K raised to 4. So, watt per square meter, fourth power of K, is SI unit of Stefan's constant. Its value numerically is 5.67 10 10 raised to minus 8 in SI units.